In order to find the resultant force F1 and F2 and the angle it makes from a positive U axis, utilizing the parallelogram law, all we need to do is translate our force F1 downwards to the head of our force F2. Similarly, F2 needs to be translated to the head of S1. This creates a parallelogram. Now, the diagonal of this will give us our resultant force. Once we have that, we have to identify the internal angles of the parallelogram here as well. Since the angle between axis V and U is 75, this gives us the angle from force F1 to the axis U as 45 degrees. Combining it with the 30 degrees gives us one of the internal angles of the parallelogram as 75. Now, by property of the parallelogram, opposite angles are equals to one another. Also, the sum of internal angles of a parallelogram is 360. Based on that, we can identify the other two angles, that is coming as 105 degrees. Now, once we have identified all the internal angles of the parallelogram, we can go ahead and pick one of the triangles and solve for the resultant force utilizing our law of sine and law of cosine. So in this case, since we know the two forces of 4 kN and 6 kN and the angle between them is 105, we can go ahead and apply our cosine law to solve for the resultant force. That is square root of our first force is squared plus the second force is squared minus 2 times the two forces and the cosine of angle between them. The result is coming as 8.03 kilonewtons. Now, once we have the resultant force, we still need to identify the angle. Here, for the triangle, we have an unknown angle theta between our force of 4 kN and the resultant force. We can identify that angle by applying our sine law. That is sine of angle theta divided by the side of a triangle opposite to that angle theta. In this case, it is 6 equals to the sine of angle 105 divided by the side opposite to the angle 105. That is our resultant force of 8.03. Simplifying, we get the value of theta as 46.22. Since it is an angle between the force F1 and FR, however, we are looking for the angle of resultant force from the positive U axis, and the angle between the force F1 and the positive U axis is 45 degrees. We can simplify and identify the angle from the positive U axis to the FR force by subtracting 45 degrees from 46.22. That gives us the final value of 1.22 degrees.